Motorola have been winning many fans with their recent no-frills budget Androids. There's nothing overly fancy about the new Moto E second generation, but that's just fine. What there is instead is a low price tag, followed by a list of specifications that force you to double check the price and product again in case you made a mistake. This is now Motorola's ethos for the low to mid-range of the market. Simple, affordable, and reliable. It's a winning combination that is clearly being continued with the second generation of smartphones. So what's changed from the first version? Well, both this and last year's Moto E are positioned at the same place in the market, at the entry level, but just above the really cheap handsets that you should be avoiding. In 2014, the E was far less inviting than the G. It had a dual-core processor and just 4 gigs of storage. It wasn't a bad phone, but there was a considerable spec jump for not much money. In 2015, however, the reverse is true. This new Moto E moves to a quad-core processor, jumps to 8 gigs of storage, and includes LTE. Add Android Lollipop 5 out of the box, almost untouched by Motorola, and the overall package looks very enticing for just a shade over £100. So unless you want the bigger screen, it now seems silly to spend the extra money on the new G. If the first generation Moto E's design was simple, then this is even more so. There's little to be done when you have a winning formula, so Motorola have done exactly that. Very little. The screen has moved up in size to 4.5 inches. Motorola haven't built it this size with this range of Moto phones yet. The first G and 4G were 4.7 inches, so they've had to develop a new case that sticks to the current design language. The 2015 Moto E is therefore a mid-sized replica of the subtle curves and relatively chunky design that Motorola are slowly making their own. There's no need for the E to be super thin or reduce the screen bezels, it is simply functional. In fact, the size and weight become useful when thinking about the potential user base. Beyond the bargain hunters, the Moto E may well be used by an older generation, first-time users, or perhaps outdoor workers that don't want a fragile mobile computer in their pocket. The extra size and weight become a usability bonus here. The phone is durable as well. There's no IP rating, so it's not waterproof, however the thicker build allows it to take a few knocks. There's also Gorilla Glass on the screen too, so spending the day in your pocket next to your keys should be fine. Motorola have also added a notched band surrounding the phone. This thin circlet is removable and hides the SIM and SD card slots, as well as providing extra grip. The band is a little flimsy when removed, although clips into place solidly and won't come off without using force. You can also buy coloured replacement bands for some cheap customization, or drop a few pounds on an official grip shell for extra protection. Motorola keep Android very close to stock on their phones. The new Moto E has Lollipop 5 out of the box, so all of Google's new additions, including material design, user profiles, and advanced power management. Motorola install a handful of apps which might be useful to new users. Migrate is good for transferring data from old phones. Assist can deliver helpful notifications and updates throughout the day. And Alert can be configured to send a message at particular times or scenarios. A useful safety feature. These apps are lightweight and barely impact on storage or resources. Otherwise, there's nothing else on the Moto E between you and Android, making for a clean, smooth experience which can be customized as much or as little as you like within the confines of Lollipop. As an entry-level handset, you do have to accept some limitations to the system. If you start opening a lot of apps and browser tabs, then performance will take a hit relatively quickly. Heavy users should know they need to spend more, really. Entry-level components and specifications, though, are much more reasonable and reliable than a couple of years ago. £100 smartphones then could do very little well. Here, streaming Netflix or Spotify, or swapping between a handful of open tabs are all easily handled, if a touch slower than a power user is used to. The Moto E second gen is every bit as smart as phones two price brackets above it. You just need to respect the limitations of having fewer available resources. Thankfully, Lollipop's updated running app screen makes it easy to dismiss and close suspended actions. So should you buy one? Well, do you need one? Android familiars will no doubt be looking for more power out of their chosen device. The E is still very much an entry-level phone in terms of design and features. If all you're after, though, is a cheap and robust modern communicator with the ability to keep up to date with today's apps, social media, and general connected life, then the E is a great choice. For novice users, kids, young teenagers, or indeed anyone else that requires a first smartphone and doesn't have any special requirements, it's difficult right now to recommend anything other than the new Moto E. Sure, you can find some cheaper phones, although they will undoubtedly lack the prestige and build quality of the Motorola brand. They probably also won't have the 4G connectivity, which although isn't a necessity, makes the E future-proofed and compatible with the newest data contracts and network deals. The only real reason to move away from the E would be to increase the screen size or camera quality. Both are tough to do if you're shopping on a budget. Aside from Sony, no one really does decent cameras on cheaper phones, and even cheap Sonys with a decent camera will command a considerable amount more money than the Motorola E. The E's camera is passable at best, and you can't really ask for more at this price. It's not the best camera out there, but for just over £100, it gets the job done. The E should really do well everywhere, as a bargain hunter's dream in established markets, or as a durable communicator from a respected manufacturer in emerging markets. If you've got 100 notes spare and need a stopgap replacement phone, a teenager's gift, or a new phone for an elderly relative, the E should be right at the top of your list.